tongue. He had a fair and handsome daughter. She was courted by a fine young man who was a servant to her father. But when her parents came to know, they swore they'd send him from the island. The maid, she knew her heart would break had she to part from young Matt Hyland. Straightway unto her love she goes, into his room him to awaken, saying, "Arise, my love, and go away. This very night you will be taken. I overheard my father say, in spite of me, he would transport you. So arise, my love, and go away. Right well I do adore you." "Oh, must I go?" he says to her. "Oh, must I go without my wages? Without a penny in my purse, just like a poor forlorn stranger. Here's 50 guineas in bright gold, and that's far more than father owes you. So take it now and go away. I wish to God I'd gone before you." They both sat down upon the bed, just for the side of half one hour, and not a word did either speak, but down their cheeks the tears did shower. She laid her head upon his breast, and round his neck her arms entwined them. "Not a duke, nor lord, nor earl I'll wed. I'll wait for you, my own Matt Hyland." The lord discussed with his daughter fair, one night alone in her bedchamber, saying, "I give you leave to bring him back, since there's no one you style above him. She wrote a letter then in haste, but in her heart was still repining. She brought him back to the church the when, and made a lord of young Bat Hyland.